Hey guys, so today we're going to go over how to install Python and then install Google App Engine so that you can get going on the homework. That's really the main point of this homework, to get you up and running so that for the rest of the homeworks, you actually have a good handle on how to start, and we can just go over how to actually start building some real-world web applications. So, okay, let's start out. So here I'm at www.python.org. Go ahead and go there, and then you'll get this link and go down to Download Python Now. And the good thing is that if you're on Mac or Linux, then you probably already have Python installed. You shouldn't need to get anything. If you do, then you can go ahead and install it from here. So down here, what you want to click on is, if you're installing Windows, then either a 64-bit system down here or a 32-bit. You simply click on there and install it like you would normally on a Windows system. Same thing with the Mac system. On Linux, you can install a source tarball, but honestly, you probably already have it, and there's an easier way to do that with your package manager. I'll have a list of instructions for some of the more common package managers for Linux up in the forums, so we're not going to go over that right now. But go ahead and open it, for example, right there, and then install it as you normally would. It shouldn't take more than a few minutes. And after that, once we have Python installed, we have everything we need for Google App Engine. So let's go ahead and install that. Now, Google App Engine is right here. If you don't want to type all of this in, just Google App Engine, and it should be the first option on the search results page. So before we go ahead and sign up, we're going to install the software development environment, and it's pretty easy to use for the most part. So we're going to go over here to Downloads. We're going to want the Python version of it. So either the Windows, the Mac, or the Linux, depending on what platform you're on. Don't worry about the MapReduce bundle. That's not something we need to worry about right now. So go ahead and open up whichever one is appropriate for your system. All of them are super simple to install. Once you've got it installed, we're going to open up Google App Engine, and it opens into this screen right here. Okay? Now, what we need to do is open up a new application. So go to File, New Application, and then that should open up this right here. We'll go ahead and install it under, let's say, Hello-Udacity. Create, and there we go. Okay, so there are a couple things to look at. Now, we can open up the files that this automatically creates. So go to the path, which you see right here. And there's really only one file you need to worry about, and that's main.py. There are a few other files in that directory. We're not going to worry about them right now. We'll explain it later. There's not much to it, really. Here's your main file for your web application, Hello Udacity. So open main.py, and it's really a pretty short file. And now you need to change this to print out Hello Udacity. We can run this. You see that it's running on port 8081. Steve talked about ports early in the course. So what we're going to do is open up localhost 8081. And you see Hello World. Now, you're going to have to change this to print out Hello Udacity. But the hard part, the part we're really interested in, is actually installing this so you're ready for other homework assignments later on when we're building some web applications with some actual content. Now we've got it running on our local system, but obviously, well, hopefully, we can't see your local system. So we need to actually sign up for Google App Engine. So let's go back to the main page that we were at before and sign up for an account with them. It's very simple. And once you have all of your information there, then all you have to do to put this up online is deploy it to your account and password, sign in, and it will automatically load all these things. And then, once you're done, you should be able to go to the Google App Engine website and check out your web app. Now, I haven't loaded this on yet, but once you do, you should get the same results from there that you do from your local host. And that's about it. All you have to do is change this to Hello Udacity and then load up the URL, whatever this happens to be. This is Hello Udacity in mine. In yours, it would be whatever this is. And put that in for the homework assignment, and you should be good to go.